Y'all do go home, party, then come to school, then you go to sleep, and then this wake me up at the end of the period.
They're gonna realize they've got to get more skill and more knowledge to compete in the world. And I believe therefore candidates and the public are gonna demand about what you're gonna do about education.
And I can't read, can't write. It's time for a fight.
My reputation is worth more than my grade point average. Holla at your boy.
Well, you be in the hallway so much, do you get a grade for being in the hallway?
Just an A in hallway. My lips popping, my hair popping. Who cares about grades? I don't.
Everything is turned in.
Oh, I may not make no money doing this, but I don't have to do work.
I need a distraction, somebody please pick on me.
I can't stay focused. Man, when I grow up, I'm gonna marry me a baller, man. I ain't going to college.
Bro, you going to the water today?
Bro, you're a little homo person, man. You gay.
She says I'm gay.
Yeah.
How fast can I get kicked out of class? How fast can I get kicked out of class?
How fast can I get kicked out of class?
One good high-stakes test each year can give the public a fair indication of how students are progressing. Listener Bart Binning of Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, thinks the real problem is unqualified teachers. He wrote, "Standardized testing is a necessity because of tenure. Incompetent teachers are not fired, and students taught by incompetent teachers do not learn the elementary requirements needed to be successful. Come up with a way to get rid of bad teachers," he said, "and the reason for standardized testing disappears."
Is it what the book is about, is that sheriffs in Alabama and Georgia and Mississippi and Florida were specifically compensated for the number of men they arrested and then sold into involuntary servitude. And so the economic incentives of the criminal justice system